Frontenac Cycle. Today I am with Pete Dawson, one of the fabulous directors at the Mountain Bike Club here in Kingston, and we're going to talk to you today a little bit about the club. So Pete, tell us a little bit about yourself. Where are you from and how'd you end up in Kingston?
Okay, well I'm from just outside of Peterborough, about 2 hours away from here. Moved to Kingston about 10 years ago and took me a little while, a couple of years before I found Mountain Bike Kingston, but at that point in my life I did really like trail riding and I found myself driving, you know, an hour to just to go for a trail ride. So I'm certainly glad I found this place. A few years in, I wanted to be a little bit more involved. It's such a great club, and I just wanted to be able to give back. So there was an opening on the board, and I volunteered.
Cool.
Oh, board shorts.
Vanilla? IPA all the way. Both?
Both?
Mountain bike is my first love. Sometimes both, actually. More bar because gel rots your teeth. I don't watch movies. Flavor of the week, actually. I don't know. Fox. You can't really have one without the other.
Ouch.
Oh. You want to cut to his face right now?
All right, Pete, tell us a little bit about the club. What is it?
Well, Mountain Bike Kingston is a, first and foremost, a trail network, but more than that, it's a community of riders within the Kingston region. Kingston's unique in that there isn't a whole lot of public land that allows mountain biking within the vicinity of the city. So about 20 years ago, when previous riders had lost access to some government land, this club was formed, and it's grown over the years. It now has just roughly 1,000 acres of land, roughly 50 kilometers of trails, and roughly 2,500 members within the community.
Impressive. Yeah. So Pete, 1,000 acres, that's a lot of land. Can you tell us about the owners of that land?
Well, yeah, it's not us, but this club exists largely because of about 10 gracious landowners who have donated their land towards our trail network. So we maintain a large liability policy for those landowners, and each one of them is named individually on that policy. And we then maintain the trails on their land and through a network of volunteers and trail ambassadors and whatnot.
Awesome. So with all that land and all those trails, maintenance might be an issue. How do you guys manage that?
Well, we have a network of volunteers. We have build days in the fall. We also have the odd build day in the spring as well, when the ground's soft and easy to work with. Largely, there's a couple of individuals that spearhead most of the building. Our main landowner is also our general manager for the club, and really most of it is his vision. But what we're sitting in now is actually a couple of other very dedicated club members that had this vision of building a skills course near to the parking area where people can grow and develop as mountain bikers. And really, it was something that they put in place a couple years ago, and it's been just an excellent addition to the club.
Awesome. Yeah. So you mentioned approximately 50 kilometers of trails. Do you have a little bit of something for everyone?
Yeah, we've got 5 distinct loops, and really what's closest to the main parking area is typically the easiest. Now, I say 5 loops, but really the center loop has about 4 different variations where you can cut it short or you can make it shorter or longer. The shortest loop of all of them is what we call the demo loop. It's a lot of this crushed gravel that you might be able to see in the foreground here. So it's very weather resistant. It can be open most of the year outside of freeze and thaw periods. It's about 3.5 kilometers, and it takes you down the hill into the woods and then back up the hill to the parking area.
So you get a good taste of it.
You get a good taste, yeah, and if you are on your first bike ride ever, it's certainly a good place to start.
Cool.
The further things away are certainly a little bit more technical, and the southern end of our properties are the most difficult. Nothing too crazy, but some very interesting stuff.
Yeah. So you ride here all the time. What's your favorite trail?
I like them all, but I have to say the Ridge is probably my favorite. It's changed a lot over the years. It's got some pretty exciting new additions for this season, actually. But yeah, it's technical, it's challenging, it's got some good flow, it's got a little bit of downhill, lots of climbing. It's just a great trail.
So you've been biking for a while now. You must have a good crash story or two. Anything? Any broken bikes, broken bones?
Well, I mean, Yeah, lots of broken bits on my bike. No catastrophic failures mid-ride, but touch wood, the only broken bone I've ever had was from skiing. So I like to think of mountain biking as a little bit safer than some other sports, because half the time when you do have a crash, you hit something soft.
So this is a private club. What is required of members, and what's expected?
So first, people have to actually become members, which can be done through our website. There's an electronic registration and waiver process to go through. And then members have to pick up one of these fancy tags. These are color keyed for the year in the current year. Our season runs from May to May in to coincide with our insurance policy. And these tags basically just serve as a visual indicator from a distance that somebody's registered and been through that waiver process, so they're not a threat to one of the landowners, from a liability standpoint, that is.
Thanks a lot, Pete, for joining us on the video today. I appreciate you telling us about the trails.
Oh, thanks, Graham. Thanks for having me on your channel. And guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, smash that like button.
And how do they subscribe?
Well, they can click the subscribe button. And if you want to get notified every time these guys post an awesome new video, ring the notification bell. Thanks so much.
Awesome. Where can they hit some sweet dirt jumps? Is this the place for it?
can we start that over again?